today I will explain bee tree. So first, what is bee tree? Bee tree is balanced multi-way search tree. Okay, see here the B for balance. Don't confuse that. The number of students confuse that ki B for binary. Here in the B tree, B for balanced. What is the meaning of here balanced? If we consider suppose the binary search tree, then if this is a tree where all the leaves are at the same level, and on the other end, if we consider this tree, this binary tree, both are binary tree. So this tree is more balanced as compared to this tree. So here in the B tree, the balanced word means all the leaf nodes here in B tree are at same level. Okay, multi-way means here in the case of binary tree is a two-way tree, because every node is having two children. So here the bee tree is a multi-way search tree. There can be the number of children or multiple branches. That's why we call it multi-way. Now the search tree, the simply the binary search tree or binary tree, the difference is that is suppose this is a node and x, then we say suppose 50 and 60, 55 and 80, 40, 30, 45. So what we say that x, all the binary search tree, the search characteristic means that all the keys on the left subtree are less than the key at x, and all the keys on the right subtree of x is greater than the value at x. As the tree is defined recursively, so this holds for every root node. Okay, so the same search characteristic hold in bee tree. So bee tree is balanced multi-way search tree. Another, simply the bee tree, here the main advantage of bee tree is that in one node we can store the large amount of data. That's why the bee tree is used to store the data on secondary storage devices. Previously what data structure we have analyzed, like array or linked list tree, the data is stored on primary memory. So when we compute the complexity of these data structures, then we do not consider the disk access time. Here the bee tree is used for external storage devices where the bulk of data is stored. So simply the disk access time is important. Disk access time means the simply not all the information can be accommodated on at the same time on the primary memory, because we are considering the large amount of data. So when I want to store a large amount of data on any data structure, then all the information cannot be accommodated in primary memory, as the cost of primary memory is very high. So at any time, the simply one or two pages we keep in the primary memory, and the all other pages kept in the secondary storage devices. And here the disk access time in the sense that because the one page in the memory, and when we perform any changes, then the corresponding page will be moved from secondary storage device to primary storage device for computation. Similarly, if any changes performed on the particular data, the change page or the change node can be written into the disk. So the complexity or the analysis of the bee tree is measured in terms of two parameters. One is disk access time, and the second one is what? The One is disk access time, and the second point is CPU or the computation time. Okay, so all the algorithms related to B-tree, the complexity will be measured in with two parameters: disk access time and the computation time. Means for any particular operation, how many disk read are required and how many disk write. Because the reason is that when this disk access time is not required, in the case the data structures are stored in primary memory. But if the data structures are stored in secondary storage device, then we know that the secondary storage access time in the secondary storage device are much larger than the access time from primary memory. So simply here the disk access time is one of the major factor in computing the complexity of algorithm related to B-tree. Now again I am saying that B-tree is used to store the data on external storage device where the bulk of data is stored. So the size of one node can be equal to the size of the page. Here the page, the size of the page varies according to the disk unit used. Like in somewhere the some secondary storage page size is 512 byte or track or sector, or it is a block of information. So simply just it depends on what is the size of the page. Accordingly the size of the node varies. Okay, so now the before giving the formal definition of B-tree, first I want to give the idea how to create a B-tree, and I want to draw the B-tree, then I will explain the definition of B-tree. Okay, so simply just every B-tree, here every B-tree is characterized by a constant called the degree of B-tree. Degree of B-tree, let's say T greater than or equal to 2 always. Actually just this degree can be equal to the one page size. It may be equal to the one sector of the hard disk, like say suppose the 512 byte, because the one node of the B-tree we can store the number of amount of data. So the why just we are storing large amount of data on a single node, because we want to reduce disk access time. When we store the large amount of data, if the T is very large, it means the to store the large amount of data the height is less. So here in the typical B-tree of height less than or equal to 10, we can store millions of data in the B-tree by taking suitably the T is large enough. Okay, actually the T, first when you are going to create a B-tree, this is characterized by the degree of the tree. Always you decide ki what is the degree of tree T. Okay, in when we create B-tree, then the for every node there are lower and upper bound on the basis of this degree. Okay, so here just if the degree of the tree is T, okay, then there is a lower bound and upper bound on number of keys that can be stored in lower bound and upper bound on number of keys that can be stored in a node. Okay, so the reason is that ki here suppose this I have taken the T as 512 and I am storing only one element in the B-tree. This is not the case. To maintain the height of the tree, or simply all the leaf are at the same level, simply there is some lower bound and upper bound on the number of keys. Okay, so the lower bound is with the all the notes, all notes, all the notes other than all the notes other than root must have at least t minus 1 keys. Okay, all the notes other than root must have at least t minus 1 keys, where t is a degree of the B tree. Okay, so simply just accept the root node. All the nodes must have at least t minus 1 keys, and all the internal node. All the internal node means including, excluding the leaf node. All the internal nodes must have at least t children. At least t children. Okay. What it is saying that all the internal nodes, all the internal node means no, all the nodes other than leaf node must have at least t children. Always the children are one more than the number of keys stored in a node. For example, in a binary tree we store one key, so there are two children. So here the minimum keys that can be stored in any node, internal node, is t minus 1. So the at least t children. Okay. And what is the minimum number in the root, for the root? If a tree is not empty, if tree is not empty, then root node must have at least one key. Okay. This is the lower bound on the knee, the first point. The second point is here. The second point, all the nodes must have at most 2t minus 1 keys. Okay. All the nodes must have at most 2t minus 1 keys, and all internal nodes must have at most 2t children. Okay. So now when we create B tree, always remember two things. First, we have to define carefully the degree of B tree. What is the degree? Okay. And degree we always take greater than or equal to 2. Now, this minimum number of keys at any particular time, minimum number of keys other than root are at t minus 1, and the maximum number of keys are 2t minus 1. Minimum number of children in any node other than the leaf node are t, and the maximum number of children in all internal node are 2t. On this, simply just first I am creating what? The B tree. So suppose I am giving how to insert one element into the B tree. Just first I will create the B tree and the drawing of B tree. Then I will explain the formal definition of B tree. Okay. Suppose the data is coming like this: 10, 20, 5, 30, 7, 9, 8, and so on. Okay. 8, say suppose 40, 50, 60. 65 and so on. Okay, this is the data what I want to insert in the B tree. Okay, so first the B tree is empty. Okay, and here again I said that what? T I am taking 2. So T, so minimum keys that can be stored in a node is T minus 1, that is 1, and the maximum keys what we can store is 2T minus 1. 2t minus 1, 2t minus 1 is, t is 2, so 2 into 2 minus 1, that is 3. Okay, so the maximum 3 keys can be stored in a node, and the minimum 1 key. Okay, so first 10,
So I will create a node, say 10. Carefully see, just 10. Okay. Now, the next node is 20. So this node is not full because the maximum number of keys can be stored in a trees. So simply just, and I said that ki this is what search tree. So all the keys in a node will be stored in non-decreasing order. So simply the 20. So here the 20 will be stored in the next. This is simply the number of keys in a node will be stored like array. Key 1, key 2, key 3 and so on. Key 2t minus 1, because in a particular node there can be the maximum 2t minus 1 keys can be stored. Okay, so 10 20. So now 10 20. Now next is what? 5. So 5 we add in this. So simply what here the 5. Now 5 10 20, always remember that the keys in a node are stored in non-decreasing order. Okay, now 30. See, the 30 cannot be stored in this node as the node is full, because the degree of tree is 2 and the maximum number of keys that can be stored in a B tree is 3. So now just here the node is splitted. There is a concept of splitting. So simply the node is splitted, and simply the node is splitted from the middle. Means left side the t minus 1 and the right side t minus 1. So how this? Simply just this node is 10 will move to the root and the two child will be created. Like one is what? 5, and the second is 20. Okay. And this you can, this 10. 10 is moved to the upper node, 10, and simply two more node is created as a left child and right child. This 5 will become the left child of 10, 20 will become the right child of this. So here the height of the tree is increased. As in the case of binary search tree, when you insert any node, then the height of the tree is increased from the bottom. Here the height is increased from the upper. Now the height of the tree is increased, and always remember the height of the tree can only increase when the root is full. Okay, so here at this time height of the tree is 1, and all the leaf node are at the same level. The next thing you always remember, for every insertion you start from root. Okay, so the next is what? 30. I want to insert 30 in this B tree where the root node is this one. Suppose I am saying that this is R. R is pointer to the root node at this time. Okay, so this is 10. Okay, and here now 30. So first what key? So simply here what key I want to insert? Here I am writing minimum keys is t minus 1, maximum keys is 2t minus 1, that is 2, and this is 3, sorry 1. Okay, now 30. So next key what I want to insert is 3, k equal to 3. So simply when I am going to 30, k equal to 30, this key I am going to insert in this key. Carefully see, just we start always from the root. So first I will check whether the root is full or not. If the root is not full, then find the appropriate child. Child means this is C1 child of R, this is a C2 child of R, and so on. Okay, so simply here what the C1 child, so simply 30 is greater than 20. So we move to this child, and now the 30, because here this node is having the space, so 30. And all the insertions will be done at leaf. All the insertions will be done at the leaf. So here the 30 inserted. Okay, and always remember that in the keys in a node should be in non-decreasing order. Okay. Just here 7 again you start from, so key is now key is what? 7. Okay, so here this 7, So first we compare the whether the first we check whether the root is full or not. Root is full? No, root is not full. So simply find the appropriate children where we want where we have to move. So simply 7 is less than 10. So the appropriate subchild where the 7 can be inserted is C1. Okay, so we move here and simply the 7 is inserted. 5 and 7. Now the next key is 9. Next step, K equal to 9. Now I want to insert K equal to 9. Again you start from root. Root is full? No. Root contains one key. Maximum number of keys that can be stored in a node is here the 3. Because the value of T is 2. The value of degree of value of T is 2. So the maximum number of keys that can be stored in a node is 2T minus 1. So 9. So node is root node is not full. Then find the appropriate child. 9 is less than 10. So simply the 9 will be inserted here. So 5, 7, 9. 5, 7, 9. Okay, now the next is 8. Next key is 8. Here K is 8. Now see, at this point first we will start from what? Root. Again I am saying, for every insertion, for every new insertion at a time, I will insert single element, and at every insertion you start from root and check whether the node is full or not. If the node is not full, then only you move downward. If the node is full, then first you have to split and then move down. Okay, now here 10. So simply 8 is compared with 10 as the root is not full, and now check the appropriate child. 8 is less than 10. So simply 8 is less than 10. So we move here. So here this is what this child is what. If this is this node is say suppose X pointer, then this is what? C1X. Okay, C1X. So simply the C1X is pointer to the this child, C1 child. Now simply 5, 7, 9. So here this node is full. So now here 8 cannot be stored. So what we do? We split this node. And split from what? Split from the middle. Carefully see the 2T minus 1. Okay? So 2T minus 1 keys in the node which is full. So when you split, you always split that what? The T minus 1 data here. And always you simply go the Tth key. Just 1, 2, 3. So T minus 1 on the left child and T minus 1 on the right child, always Tth key will move to the upper node. Okay, so here after the splitting of this node, okay, kaunsi node is split ho rahi hai, you always mark that this node is splitted. Okay, so whenever there is a split, you draw the separate B tree, otherwise you can overwrite in the same. Okay, so here 7 move upward. So after this insertion, what? K equal to 8. Just the splitting is what? The 8. Now the root, the number of elements in the root will be increased. 8, 10, and now, 7. 7 will be moved up. At present, I have not inserted 8. First, I will make space here to insert 8. So for this node is splitted. Here Tth key will be moved to the parent. Okay, and then simply here this is divided into two node 5, and here this is 9 and 20 30 20 30. Again see, just after inserting K equal to 8, this is the tree. Again, all the leaf nodes are at the same level and the height of the B tree is 1. Okay. Now, the next key what I want to insert is K equal to, this is when I have inserted K equal to 8. Okay. Now, in this tree, I am inserting K equal to 40. k equal to 14. So always we start from root. Okay, root. So root is not full. So we find the appropriate child. So 40 is what? Greater than 7. 40 is greater than 10. So we will move in this child and here we insert 40. Okay. Now the next key is 15. Okay. So when we insert k equal to 15. Okay. So.
Okay, just one more thing. After splitting, the 8 will be inserted here. Okay, I forgot to mention this insertion. So, first splitting will be performed and after that the current key will be stored in the node. Now, the next key, K is what? 40. Okay, so node is, root node is not full, so simply just 40 is greater than 10, so here I will move and the 40 is stored in this node. Now the next is k equal to 50, k equal to 50, so again the loop will start from what? K equal to 50, the always we start from the root. First check, रूट इज फुल. बस यहाँ पे गलती होती है कि आप जो है एकदम से डायरेक्ट लीफ पे पहुँच रहे हो, बस यहीं पे कंफ्यूजन है. फॉर एवरी इंसर्शन यू स्टार्ट फ्रॉम रूट एंड फर्स्ट चेक वेदर द रूट इज फुल और नॉट. एंड एक्चुअली दिस इज अप्लाइड टू ऑल द नोड्स. हेयर देर इज ओनली वन लेवल, दैट्स व्हाई आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट रूट. सो यू स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द रूट एंड व्हेन यू आर मूविंग डाउन from the root to down in at any path, if you get the node which is full, so before moving the down towards again, just first split the node, then only move down. I will give you the reason why I am taking this condition. Okay, so here k is 50, so the root is not full, so root is not full, so I will be here. Now here this node, so 50 will be inserted in this node. This is the proper place for 50, but this node is full. So first we split this node. So whenever there is a split, you draw the separate tree. Okay. So here, say, I'm drawing here again, 7, 10, 5, 8, 9 and 20, 30, 40. Okay. And now I am inserting what? K equal to 50. K equal to 50. So we start from root. Root is not full. So we come here because this is the node where the 50 can be inserted. So simply here the 50 is, but 50 cannot be inserted because this node is full. So first the here this node is splitted. Okay, so splitting is performed. So here the tth key of this node will be moved to its parent, 7, 10 and 30, and this is what, 5, 8, 9 and 20, this will be divided into 2, 20 and what, 40, and because the key, now this is after splitting and what node I am inserting, 50, the new node I am writing here, this in this T, 50, और जो नोड शिफ्ट हुई है वो ये नोड शिफ्ट हुई है. ठीक है, ये की, सॉरी, ये की जो है ऊपर शिफ्ट हुई और इससे जो है ये नोड टू पार्ट्स में स्प्लिट हो गई. ठीक है, सो द लेफ्ट चाइल्ड ऑफ 30 विल बिकम 20, वन नोड, एंड द राइट चाइल्ड 40, एंड देन 50 विल बी इंसर्टेड इन दिस नोड. ओके, नाउ हियर यू कैन यूज द डिफरेंट पेन फॉर द सोइंग द प्रॉपर इंसर्शन. नाउ द नेक्स्ट इज, नेक्स्ट की is what, 60 key is 60. Now see carefully, here I start always from root node.
root node is full. So before moving down, first you have to split the root node. Okay, so simply when you are inserting k equal to 7, then this node is splitted. Okay, and the 10 is moved to upper, and here this simply the 10 is moved, and this will become left child, this will become right child. See, ten, and this is left child, this is right child. See, without disturbing other pointers, the blow pointer, simply just what the this node, the previous node will be splitted into two part. The 10 moved to the root node. Now the height of the tree has been increased. So height of the tree can only be increased when the root is full. Okay, and the next is, at any particular time you can see in a bee tree that all leaf node are at the same height or are at the same level. Okay, now the next is what? K equal to 65. So k, this is what first after splitting, see the root node is splitted, and I will insert 60. So again it will start from, but after splitting again the 60 again after splitting the 60 to be inserted. So here the 60 is greater than 10, and then 60 is greater than 30, so 60 is inserted here. Okay, now next, suppose the element what I want to insert is, say, suppose 70, 75 and so on. Okay, 70, or simply say suppose 3 or 4 in this way. So if k equal to 70, so again it will start from root is not full. So simply just check what is the appropriate subtree or the sub pointer to the subtree where the 70 can be inserted. So because 70 is greater than 10, so we follow this child, and 30, the 70 is greater than 30, so we follow. Now this node is full, so this node is full, so before insertion this node is splitted. Okay, so here the splitting of this node, and 50 move up. Okay, so here the 50, and this is 40, and this node is divided into two node, and this 40 will become the left child of 50, and the 60 will become the right child of 60. Okay, sorry, right child of 50. Now 70 will be inserted, so 70 will be inserted here in this node 70. Okay, now the next is 3. I want to insert 3. K is 3. So 3 is, root is not full. So simply just 3. 3 is 3 is less than 10. So we move on this path. Again this node is not full, so move this path, and 3 is inserted here. 3. Okay. Now the next, suppose I am inserting 4. K equal to 4. So 4 is less than 10. So we move here. First check. At each level you check whether the root node, whether the node is full or not. If the node is full, then first split and then move down. Only this is very important point. You have to remember that you start for every insertion from root and moving from root to leaf, because ultimately we are inserting the key onto the leaf. So from moving the root to leaf, in the path from root to leaf, at any particular point, if the node is full, first you have to split, then move down. Okay, so here k equal to 4, first root is not full, so find its appropriate child. So here this 7, this is not full, then simply move here. Now this node is full, so 5 move here, 5, and this node is splitted into two part. The left part of left child of 5 is this, and right child form, and 4 is inserted. So here the 3, 4. Okay. Now, suppose the next element is 80, 90. Okay. So k equal to 80. K equal to 80. So first, start from root. This is full? No, this is not full. Then, this is appropriate child. So 80 is greater than 10. So we move to this child. Now, 80 is, again, check first before moving, you check this node is full or not. This node is not full. So find the appropriate child. So 80 is greater than 50. So 80 is inserted here. So I have inserted 80 here. Okay. Now the next element is next key 90. Okay. Again, we start from root. Root is full? No, root is not full. Find the appropriate child where the 90 can be inserted. So we move to this child. Now, this node is not full. So find the appropriate child 60, 70, 80. Now, this node is full. So here the 90 cannot be inserted. So before inserting, this node is splitted. Okay. So this node is splitted. And after splitting, what happened? See, 70. This one, okay, this 60, this node is 70 and this is splitted, and after splitting, what, the 90 to be inserted here, 80 and 90, okay. Now, the next is, say, suppose the 95, the next key, I want to insert 95, so again, you start from the root. Root is full? No, root is not full. So find the appropriate child in which the 95 can be inserted. So the appropriate child is this. This is full? Yes. This node is full. So before moving down, first you have to split. Now see the reason why. If suppose you are splitting, so what you are doing? You are simply moving tth key to its parent node. What I am doing, just when a node is at any particular time, if you are at the downward, you are moving, and simply at any particular time, if the node is full, so what in the splitting, what I am doing, I am just simply moving tth key to its parent. If suppose I move down, because actually the reason is that all the keys, all the nodes are stored on the secondary storage device. So just if you are 50 moving and this is full, then this is full. So again, the some type of the disk access or backtracking is required. So here, the before moving down, we make sure that there is a space in this node so that in the below downward, if any node is full, then there can be one key accommodated. Okay, so here this node is full. So before moving down, first I have to split this node. So here this node is splitted. So 50, tth key 50 will move up, and the left child, and this is, and this is the left child and this is the right child. Now we start, I was here, this, and this node is splitted. Okay, so this node is splitted. So now carefully we check the 95 will be on the left child or right child, because previously I was in this node, but now this node is splitted into two nodes. So again, the key can be in this part or the key can be in this part. So here the 95 here to move here. So simply now this 95 is inserted. Okay. So this is the concept of inserting a key into the B tree. So simply B tree, all the leaf node are at the same level, and at the time of insertion, you always remember that when you start for every insertion from root, and the keys are inserted at the leaf node. From root to leaf, in the path, if you are getting any node which is full, first you have to split the node by moving the tth key to its parent, and then move down, and
find the appropriate subtree where the key can be inserted. So this is the B tree. This is one B tree with degree T equal to 2. Okay, now I am giving the formal definition of the B tree. Okay, so here this actually I am teaching this concept because in the some of the book there is a concept of degree, some of the book there is a concept of order, but the degree and order both decide the branching factor, because I said that this is a multi-way search tree. So multi-way, so I am teaching this concept or a B tree from the book Introduction to Algorithm by Thomas H. Cormack. So simply refer this all these splitting and the concept of T and the definition, the Cormack book for the Introduction to Algorithm for B tree. Okay, now see this is definition, and this definition I have written from Cormack. Okay, so now the B tree T a B tree is a rooted tree, like a binary search tree. B tree, just look at my vertical. B tree a T is a rooted tree. The one node is what? Root node, with the following property. Every node X has the following field. Now just here, the every node X has the following field. Here in the Cormack book, if suppose X is a pointer to the node, then generally in C language we write X to N or X to key to access the field. This is a pointer and arrow and the field name. Here in the Cormack book, simply the the way of accessing is N is the what? The field and X. So everywhere I will use this notation. This simply means the nth field of node pointed by X. X is a pointer and N is its field. Simply key, say suppose key of X. So in this way, the X is a pointer to the node, and I'm talking about here the field key. Okay, so what it is saying that every node X has the following field. First see here, this is a node. So here the node contains what? The keys. One node contains the keys, and at most how many keys? 2T minus 1 keys if it is not leaf node. Okay, sorry, if 2t minus 1, yes, every node is having 2t minus 1 keys. Okay, but if it is not leaf, then every node has what? 2t children. Okay, and so simply just nx, the number of keys currently stored in node x. So simply maximum number of keys that can be stored in a node is 2t minus 1. But what number of nodes currently stored? Like here, the nx is 2, here nx is 2, here nx is 1. The number of keys currently stored in a node x. Okay, suppose for this definition I am taking this as pointer to x. Okay, so suppose I am defining the structure of the node in using C language syntax. Struct node type def. Type def struct node. So here what it is saying that the n in the x, n is what? The number of keys currently stored in node x. So simply I am giving one field in int n. Why I am giving the n? The maximum, there is a lower bound and upper bound on the number of keys, but at any particular time how many keys are stored between the lower and upper bound? So just this is the value of n for this node is 2, the value of n for this node is 1. So here this is n. The second, nx keys themselves is stored in non-decreasing order. This is okay. Just the number of keys kitni ho gayi, is node mein number of keys 3 hai, and all the keys are stored in non-decreasing order. Okay, and so that simply, so here if there are nx number of keys, so there is an array. Int, suppose the value of the keys are integers, so int key, and this is what? The maximum number of the memory is allocated to the maximum, 2 into t minus 1. Here the t is declared as constant. 2T-1. The max memory is allocated for the maximum number of keys in a particular node. Okay, so maximum number of keys, but at present the whatever the number of keys will be stored in non-decreasing order. So simply just here 80, 90 and 95. Okay, the next is leaf of X. So this node is having one field, that is what int leaf. This here, this is a boolean field, but C language doesn't permit the boolean. So if value of leaf is 0, it means it is internal node, and leaf equal to 1, it is the leaf node. Here the if the leaf node. Okay, and if suppose this is true, this is simply for all the nodes, the number of keys currently stored. N is what? Number of keys currently stored in a node. Key 2TI-1 is simply the maximum number of keys. So this is an array. Key 1X, like here. Suppose this is X. So key 1X is 10. Key 2X is what? 50. Okay, and so on in this way. Okay, so key 2T-1, maximum number of keys 2T-1, any particular time, this is what? Key nx, we what give the number of total. So key 1 key 2 key nx x, this is the, this concept means the nx number of key. This is here the value of n is what? 2. So simply key 1 key 2, so key 1 key 2, and nx will give you the number of keys currently stored in x. Okay, so this is true for all the node. But if suppose the node is internal, if the node is an internal node, then there are 2T children except the leaf node. For the leaf node, this boolean field is 1. If the node is a leaf node, it means all the children of the leaf node are null. But other than the leaf node, the every node is having what? The nx is the number of keys. So nx plus 1 number of children. So here the children is pointed to the same self-referential structure, struct nd, strict. This is again an array, and now this is 2t, because the maximum number of keys in a node is 2t-1. So the maximum number of children 2t. Okay, so here c is the children, and this is pointer. Okay, now just with this structure I am explaining this thing. Every node X has the following fields: nx, n. Just here X is pointer to the node. Every node X has the following fields: number of keys currently stored in X. Second, the nx keys themselves is stored in non-decreasing or increasing order, so that key 1X is less than or equal to key 2X. Key 1X, I said that this is what? Key 1X, this is key 2X, and so on. And the total key nx. Nx is the number of keys currently stored in X. Leaf X is a boolean value, and this is true if X is a leaf node, and this is false if X is the internal node. Each internal node X also contains Nx plus 1 pointers. See, here for X, the value of N is 2. N is what? Nx. For this node, Nx. Nx. Just don't confuse that. This is simply you interpret like x dot n. Okay, I am referring the nth field of the node pointed by x. Okay, because this definition I have taken from the Coleman book. So simply I am using the same notation. Nx. So nx is the number of keys. So simply just each internal node. So here this is what? The nx is equal to 2. So how many children are? 3. So nx plus 1, number of children for all internal node. So their number of keys 2, so 3 children. Their number of keys 2, so 3 children. Their number of keys 1, so 2 children. Their number of keys 1, and these are the leaf nodes, so no children. Okay, so this is each internal node X also contains nx plus 1 pointers, c1x, c2x, so on, to its children. Leaf nodes have no children, so their ci fields are undefined.
here the, this is the structure of the node that is to be for all the nodes in the B tree, whether it is leaf node or internal node. So if the node is leaf, then the child pointers are undefined or it is none. Okay, now the third point is the key ki separate the range of keys stored in each subtree. This property is due to the search, like this is a multi-way search tree. ठीक है, तो search में क्या है, ये क्या कह रहा है, ki separate the range of keys stored in each subtree. So ki x, suppose I am taking this as x, okay, I'm just explaining this point. Okay, I this is pointer to this node, and just all the keys of this node I am using key. Okay, so key 1x 10, key 2x 50. Okay, so the keys kix separate the range of keys stored in each subtree. If ki is any key stored in the subtree with root cix, ki means k1 is the key which is stored in the subtree what, c1x. So ye x hai, iska ye c1 child hai, ye c2 child hai, ye c3 child hai. Okay, so here the k1, this is what k1, theek hai. So k1 is what it is saying, that ki is any key stored in the subtree with cix. So is c1x, इसमें इस सबट्री में जितनी भी कीज होंगी, व्हाट से k1, सो k1 शुड बी लेस देन की 1x. सी व्हाट इट इज सेइंग, ऑल द कीज इन द सबट्री c1x शुड बी लेस देन की 1x. कितने, इस सबट्री में जितनी भी कीज है वो 10 से छोटी है. ठीक है, नाउ द सी इज लेस देन और इक्वल टू k2. Just k2 is what? ki is any key stored in the subtree. So जो c1 में store हमको k1 कह रहे हैं, जो c2 में store हमको क्या कह रहे हैं, k2 में कह रहे हैं. तो k2 जो है, in this subtree all the keys should be less than or equal to what, this key 2x and so on. Okay, so here this, if ki is any key stored in the subtree with root cix, k1 means I am talking about the keys in the subtree rooted at c1x. So c1x, all the keys in the subtree rooted at c1x will be less than or equal to key1x. The similarly key1x will be less than, or simply in other words you can say that all the keys in the subtree rooted at c2x will be less than or equal to key2x. So just see here, the all the nodes in this subtree are less than 10, all the keys are greater than 10 but less than 50, all the keys here in this subtree less than 50 but greater than 50, and so on. Okay, so simply all the keys here the greater than 50 but less than 10. Okay, now all the leaves have same depth which is the tree height. As I told that in the case of B tree, this is the important characteristic, that's why the disk access time is reduced. The here the height of the tree is in logarithmic, so simply just we can reduce in this way the disk access time. So all the leaves are at the same level or at the same height, that's why we call that B tree is a balanced tree. Okay, now just I explained this topic earlier, there are lower upper bounds on the number of keys a node can contain. These bounds can be expressed in terms of fixed integer, that is called degree of B tree, and this degree should be greater than or equal to 2. Okay, now every node other than the root must have at least t-1 keys, and every internal node other than the root has at least t children. Always remember that the number of children, if it is not leaf, I'm talking about the term children is only valid for the internal node, it is not valid for leaf node. So if the node is internal node,
then every node other than the root must have at least t minus, every internal node other than root has at least t children. Every node can contain at most 2t minus 1 pairs. Therefore, internal node can have at most 2t minus 1 children. We say that a node is full if it contains exactly 2t minus 1 children. And the root node, because maybe suppose I am creating a B tree with single node. So, for the minimum number of keys in a root node can be 1. So, here the fixed integer. So, this is the definition of BT. So here just every point I think you have to clear, and then please refer book also, as this is a difficult concept. Okay, thank you.